Now we're finally moving on from France, and we're moving to England. Now by the second half of the 13th century, the Gothic style has become dominant throughout Western Europe. And it will also become dominant in England, beginning with the Norman Conquest, although we see modifications to create regional styles and regional preferences. French architectural styles will quickly impact England following 1066. And what we're looking at is Salisbury Cathedral, which is particularly famous for the invention of Salisbury steak, which might not be related at all, but I'm making it up as I go. So here is Salisbury Cathedral. And this is the English Gothic style. It's a fairly squat building. We don't see the same sense of verticality here. The west wall, or the facade, which we're seeing here, is actually wider than the nave, which is unusual. You wouldn't see that, for example, in France. And we don't see any real soaring height here. But we have this great crossing tower in the center. And that crossing tower is a really dominant feature. What they're doing with that crossing tower is basically showing the power of the church, allowing everyone coming into town to see how important this structure is within that town. They use flying buttresses very sparingly. They're almost superficial in this case, since they're not really integral to the structure. And what we see is a double transept. So we have two crossings, one in the center with that great steeple that we saw, and one behind it. So this is a different form of cross that it's basically creating. We also see a rectilinear structure, a rectangular structure. There's nothing rounded here. So it's all squared off, very much in an English sort of style. The east end, unlike many of the French, where we would expect an apse or some radiating apses, instead is flat. And the choir makes up almost half the structure, if you consider the choir to be everything behind the first crossing. Behind the second crossing, it's much more in scale. And we have a lot, when we get inside, we have a lot of interesting color contrast, because what we're seeing is dark marble incorporated into the lighter stone of the cathedral to bring out details such as the rib vaults and the roof, or some of these columns denoting the different levels, the gallery, the arcade, and the clerestory. And we have that three-part elevation, something very similar to what we would see in France or elsewhere. The rib vaults are also four-part. Again, those ideas of sticking with a four-part are coming across into England. So some very different ideas, and they're really sort of, the easiest way to think of it is they're sort of simplifying the style, in part for pragmatic reasons, and in part because the English aesthetic is a little bit simpler than what you see in France. The English usually don't want to be just like the French, especially since they're pretty much constantly at war with the French through this period.